Eclectic Designs by Catherine presents
The Colors of the Summer Sky. The Colors of the World. If love is blind, why do I see you so clearly now? Perfect vision of our love somehow. Take over my mind. Oh.
For this project, you will need 2mm leather cording, acrylic paint in 3 different colors, large wooden beads, something for your painted beads to dry on, so I scrunched up some aluminum foil into a ball and then just used some nails or toothpicks, acrylic spray, epoxy cement, scissors, and a ruler. Now on to how to make the necklace. The first step is to paint the base coat. Since we have 8 beads and 3 colors, I need to paint the first 3 beads the lightest color, the next 3 beads the medium color, and the last 2 beads the darkest color. Because now we're going to paint the ombre. So I take my lightest coat and I paint half of it the medium coat. And so now to have that ombre effect, I kind of wipe off the brush a little bit and then only pull in the lightest color on half of the brush and the dark color on the other half of the brush, and then I just start like dry brushing the paint on, so then it kind of blends better. And just keep working on it until you get your desired effect. Now do the same for the medium and the dark color. Once the paint has dried, seal with acrylic spray. Measure and cut your cording to your desired length times 2. So I wanted about a 20-inch necklace, I decided to cut 40 inches. And to finish off the necklace, we're going to have the beads centered, and then just do overhand knots to keep those beads in place. To finish off the ends, I'm going to make some sliding knots, so then you can adjust the length of the necklace. So take one of the ends of the string, and then you're going to do an overhand knot by your other overhand knot on the opposite side of the end that you chose. Just like this. And then do the same for the other side with that other end and create an overhand knot right by your other overhand knot. So I do a check at the end, make sure my sliding knots are even, and as I pull the necklace, I notice that there is a gap that happens. And so I want to undo my sliding knot and just kind of readjust and make sure. That's why I have a little tail there, so then I can readjust and make the knots even. And as the final touches, I just make sure my knots are super, super tight, and then I just cut off the tails, just like this. And then I'll add a little dollop of epoxy cement just to those sliding knots and make sure that I don't get it on the main cording so then you can't even slide it. But just a tiny bit of epoxy just so then the knots do not come undone.
Vision of our love somehow take over my mind. Oh, look up into the galaxy tonight. The stars.